Bengaluru is India's illustrious IT hub that boasts the presence of some of the world's biggest corporations. It is also notorious for having earned the title of the world's most traffic congested city. During rush hour, commuters here spent an extra 243 hours stuck in traffic in 2019, the same amount of time that it takes to watch 215 episodes of the HBO series Game of Thrones. Karthik Ranganathan and Ankit Naredi are both engineers by profession.
Just a few days before the nationwide lockdown due to COVID-19, they set out to determine firsthand which mode of transport will help them decrease their travel time in the city.
We are at the Binamangala temple and we need to get to the Domdur flyover, which is approximately 2 kilometers in from here. So, Ankit, see you there.
Yeah.
It's been 10 minutes, I got stuck in traffic. It's heavy traffic here. Sometimes even for a small stretch, it takes too long and we get delayed.
It's taken me less than 9 minutes to cover the 2 kilometers from Binamangala, and Ankit is still not here.
Wow.
Heavy traffic. Yeah, lucky on a bike.
So how long it took you?
Almost 15 minutes. He's lucky enough to be on a bike. I got stuck in traffic. It took me almost 15 minutes.
Bengaluru's transport infrastructure has failed to keep pace with vehicle additions, which have been growing at an average of 10% each year for the past 18 years. Bicycling has been a part of Karthik's daily routine since his childhood. Seasoned rider, he's able to expertly navigate the city's jam-packed roads using this tried and tested environment-friendly option.
For me, I mean, so both my helmet and like my glove, so they are two non-negotiables. So the minute I take my cycle out, when I get near my cycle, so these two come along with me, right? So then, so knowing where you cycle helps. Right, so knowing your road helps, and knowing your space on the road really helps. And you do have to realize that, that you're not the biggest vehicle there.
In June 2019, Karthik volunteered to become a bicycle ambassador for his company as part of a city-wide initiative called Cycle to Work. This leadership position has enabled Karthik to encourage his colleagues to make the switch to using a bicycle and become a part of a viable and long-term solution to decongest their city. Cycle to Work was born out of the need to target people who have the option to choose between various modes of transport for work commute, and ensuring that they opt for a bicycle for that particular trip. It is the passion project of Satyanarayan Shankaran, a techie-turned entrepreneur consulting on urban mobility and data-led planning for smart cities.
There are two negative externalities that vehicles cause, motor vehicles cause, right? The cars and the private motor vehicles, they cause congestion and they cause pollution, and they are causing this together. It is not one or the other. So you can't solve only congestion and say we've solved the problem, or only pollution and say we've solved the problem.
Satya also has the unique responsibility of being Bengaluru's bicycle mayor, an honorary role commissioned by the BYCS. A Dutch non-profit working worldwide to achieve 50% of all city trips by bicycles by 2030.
I think every time a person makes this choice of trying to take a bicycle, the entire city benefits. It's one thing for you to enjoy riding the bike and make it a recreational option and get fit, be healthy, enjoy the ride. But it's another thing to make it count for the city.
He developed an algorithm that bicyclists can use free of cost to clock their daily work rides through a simple mobile application. Each trip data comprises workplace location, the route taken, distance travelled, and calculates the carbon emissions offset by the commute. This creates a public leaderboard that is updated in real time. Using technology to gamify cycling to work has generated a sense of competition among riders that fosters sustainable behavior change.
We call this bicycle stand for making the fastest jump within the leaderboard. Then we landed at number 3.
This became this daily habit of ours to see, okay, so the number of rides that we did, and how many rides did we do, right? So then did we get any new riders in, right? So that sort of became this habit within the whole team, right? So which kind of helped us and pushed the whole company to get on it.
Experts have pointed to how Bengaluru's growth into a megacity has led to an increase in pollution causing motor vehicles. The onset of COVID-19 may have led to fewer vehicles on the street, but it is estimated that by 2022, the number of vehicles in the city will cross the 1 crore mark. So, some bicycle ambassadors have taken the cycle to work movement out onto the streets.
Hello, hello, hello.
Every Friday at 8 a.m., one can witness this seemingly low-key event juxtaposed with traffic on Bengaluru's outer ring road, where vehicle speeds are typically slower than 4.5 km per hour during rush hours. Bicycle ambassador Shilpi Sahu leads this one-of-a-kind weekly volunteer event, where cycle-to-work riders come together to show strength in numbers.
Today we were expecting about 10 people to come, but because of the coronavirus, there is a work from home policy for many companies. Today, many schools are starting today. So we have very less crowd today, but typically we have more than 10.
to 2,000 people from 270 companies in Bengaluru are today registered on the Cycle to Work app. Together, they have clocked 600,000 kilometers by riding their bicycles to work just within 2 years.
People to cycle. We also want government to take notice that cyclists have always been cycling on roads. But somehow the government does not pay any attention when they come up with infrastructure. They never think about cyclists. They hardly think about pedestrians. They only think about providing roads for vehicles. Because everybody thinks that it's so hostile and such a hostile environment for cyclists that nobody cycles to work. But it's the truth is that people who drive, they don't really see anything outside. So they never see that how many cyclists are passing them by.
Traffic snarl-ups are expected to reappear in the city post the lockdown. But these citizens of Bengaluru are fighting hard to prove that bicycling could be a viable mode of transport for India's urban working classes.